Hello everyone and welcome to my new tutorial. I am SV and today I'll show you how to make a balloon simulation. In today's video, I will show you how to make balloon modeling. I will show you how to make a redshift material for this balloon. Additionally, I will show you how to make a turbulence and aerodynamic wind for simulation. And finally, I will show you how to make a clouds for redshift sky. So, if you are ready, let's start. I am in Cinema 4D and I start modeling my balloon. So I am going to sphere, make radius 40 and 36 segments. I think it will be enough. Going to front view and increase little bit scale, maybe up to 1.2, like this. Very good. So going to sphere and apply to the sphere topper tool. Going to topper, fit to apparent, and increase little bit strange, like this, maybe for beginning like this. After that, make rotation 180 degrees up to down and check again what I have. Okay, maybe I will increase little bit more up to 50% and pick up more. Okay. Yeah, looks like very nice. So very interesting. Now I create a end of this balloon. I don't know how it's calling in English, but doesn't matter. Now I start creating and you will understood what I mean. Reduce radius and make maybe 5 centimeters, like this. Okay, very good. So going to my tools and loft object, put inside, hold Ctrl on my keyboard, drag and drop little bit up, again little bit up, reduce radius, maybe like this, again up, reduce radius, and again up. Okie dok, very nice. What I have looks like very interesting. So if I check from down, I can see play. I don't like it. And now I fix this problem. I going to first my circle, hold Ctrl on my keyboard, drag and drop up and reduce size. As you can see, it's coming like this. Drag and drop up and reduce size up to, I don't know, maybe zero. Maybe zero will be good and pick up somewhere here. So what I have? I have like this. Looks like very interesting. Maybe I will just put little bit down. Maybe like this. And maybe like this. Okay. Not so bad. Just check. Yeah, maybe just little bit smaller size. Yes, maybe 4.8. And this also will be 4.8, I don't know, just little bit smaller size. Okay, what I have to do now, I'm going to one more circle created, push down somewhere here, very good, and reduce size. We are create a rope, 2 centimeters will be good. So one more, it will be maybe 0.5, and create for this sweep object like this and like this. What I have? I have very nice object, but as you can see, I have many segments, so I don't like it. I am going to settings of my circle and reduce, maybe it will be maybe 2 segments only, also natural, and I don't know, no other way. Yeah, maybe only one, like this. It will be enough. We are create a rope now. For rope, I will use a hair, standard hair. So select it, all of them, right click, connect and delete. I have like this. Going to points, select any point like this. Going to simulation, hair object and add hair. Like this. Very good. What I have? I have hair. Very nice, but it's very short. So I'm going to here, going to settings and increase maybe in twice. Check. Yeah, looks like very nice. Maybe a little bit more, 250. If I play, what I have like this. As you can see, this I have only 8 segments and my band is not so good. So I will increase segments maybe by 64. And oh yeah, very nice. You see what I have? I have very nice, very interesting animation. So for my sphere I will apply tag hair collider. If I will have many spheres, my hair will touch it and looks like very interesting animation. Okay, very good. So I have it now, and now it's not completed. My rope will be white color. Thickness will be 1 cm start and 1 cm end. And render. What I have? I have nothing. I cannot see my rope. I am going to redshift. On the redshift in beginning, I will use only 2 and 2. System. Bokeh render. Increase up to maximum. Use spiral. Going back to basic. And add some redshift sky. Okay, very nice. Check again what I have. If I will render now, yeah, I cannot see nothing. Why like this? Because settings of my hair, if I going to here, I have to apply roots as guidance because I have only one here. Check again. Yeah, very nice. I have it. I have my balloon. Looks like very interesting. What we will do now? We will start play with animation. Okay. Before this animation, first of all, I will select this, right click, and connect and delete. Okay, very good. After that, my loft object, again I select all of them, connect and delete. I put inside and inside. And finally, all of them connect, Alt G on my keyboard, and we'll call it balloon. Balloon. Very good. Inside my balloon, for my sphere, I will apply tag. Where is it? Rigid body tag. Okay, look. Just a moment. I just check if it's everything okay. Yes, everything okay. If I play now, my balloon dropping down like a rigid body. So to avoid this problem, I am going to rigid body and I am apply aerodynamics. 100 and 100. What I have? Almost nothing changed. Because I haven't any aerodynamics. So I am going to my simulation and create from particles some wind. Yeah, you see, I have wind. This wind will push my balloons to the up. I will turn like this. And I will apply also some, I don't know, maybe some turbulence. Like this. I have wind and I have turbulence. So play and check what I have. Nothing. My balloon anyway going down. Because I need to increase a wind speed, maybe up to 20. Check again. Not working. Yeah, and don't forget, yes, when you use a wind, you have use a mod for aerodynamics. Also for turbulence, you have to use aerodynamics. So check again. Yeah, you see, it's going up. Very good. So wind, maybe I will, I think I will keep a 20. For turbulence, I will use a 50 and scale 100. Check what I have now. No, it's really too much and looks like not so good. And as you can see, my balloon going up. So how we will fix this problem? Before this animation, I'm going to my connection and position, follow position, I will put, I don't know, maybe 2, just to keep my balloon somewhere here to check what is going on. As you can see, I have very strong wind and my balloon turning because I haven't center of my mass. I am going to this tag mass and custom center. I will make minus 20. Check again. Yeah, you see, like this, looks like very nice. But I think I have turbulence too much. So 50 is too much. I will reduce maybe up to 10. Check again. Yeah, and I think I already can take out this force. Yeah, very nice. My balloon going to up. You see, yes, very beautiful. So maybe just for turbulence, little bit more, maybe 20 also. Check again. No, too much. Maybe 15. Going back. No, maybe 10 we will put like before. Sorry, 10. Yeah, I think I'll keep like this. Looks like very nice. So what I will do now? I have this balloon and I have cloner connected, going to cloner mode, grid array, 3, 3, 3. Very good. You see how many balloons I have. And I maybe little bit increase up to 400, 400 and 400. Just beginning for check how it's working, how my balloon start running together. Yes, you see what is going on. And our animation almost completed. Only just few remarks we have to do. You see, all my balloons coming somewhere. Some is faster, some is not faster. So for my cloner, I will apply a random mode. Inside random mode, maybe it will be, I don't know, 5, 5. And scale, I like to make my balloons different size. So I use uniform scale. And maybe will be 0.2, like this. One it will be bigger, one it will be smaller. Maybe we also, you know what we can do? Maybe not uniform, maybe 0.2, 0.2, 0.2. So one will be big, one will be small, and all balloons will have a different size. And will be very nice. You see, some is very big, some is, no, maybe 0.1 I will use like this. Not too much different. Yeah, like this. Very good. Render and check what I have. Very nice. Play. My balloon is going somewhere to the sky. Check again. Okay. What I have to check, if it's normal speed, if it's not too fast. If it's really too fast, I have go to the wind and maybe reduce up to 15. And check again. Yeah, you see, it's very slow coming up. So I don't like it. I will keep 20 like before. Okay, now we are play with my redshift material for my balloon. I will set up camera, maybe like here. Going to IPR. Play and redshift material. So apply this redshift material to my sphere, to my here. Yes, apply here. Very good. As you can see, it automatically adds some reflection. Going to my material editor, and what we have. Standard Redshift material have diffuse color, reflection and refraction. So I need diffuse color. It will be okay, red color. A reflection, as you can see, like a mirror. I will add some roughness, maybe will be 0.3. Yeah, like this. You see, I have very nice specular and very good. Also, I will add some IOR, maybe 65, just little bit more to make it more bright. After that, I am going to refraction, because all balloons in real world have some refraction. So, but if I increase 100 up to 1, I have like a glass. As you can see, I don't like it. I don't like this glass. I will go to this settings, scene wallet, and enable it. What I have like this. But as you can see, I have some IOR, which is connected to reflection. So I going to take out this IOR like this and push it zero. Not sorry, zero, only one like this. And what I have, you see, my balloons now full reflected and I can see what is behind. Very good. So I will use for my refraction same color like on my diffuse color, like this, red also. Sorry, why it's not applied? Yeah, now it will be. Okay, red color also. And I like to reduce this refraction maybe up to, I don't know, 0.5. Just half. Like this. Very good. As you can see, I can see something behind, but it's not proper. It looks like rubber. Very good. Material for my balloons done. If you like it, send me some comments. If you have some other idea how to make this material more interesting, also for me it will be interesting to check your comments. So, and I like to make a little bit randomized. I make take this balloon, drag drop like this. I will collect seven different balloons inside in my cloner, and I will apply seven different materials to these balloons like a rainbow. So I'm going here, this will be orange. Okay, this will be yellow. Very nice. This will be green. This will be light blue. This material will be normal blue, dark blue. Very nice. And last will be pink or violet, I don't know. Okay, finito. Very good. Now my computer need the time to apply all these materials very soon. Yeah, I hope very soon it will work. So I'm open my balloons number one and apply orange. Number two, apply yellow. And for different balloons, apply different colors. In standard Cinema 4D, you have some special shader to make a different colors for all cloner object. But my version of Redshift is not working with this, so I have to apply different object with different materials. So I am render now, and what I have, you see, looks like very very nice, like some holiday. Okay. Now I am apply a camera. Push somewhere here, make a camera. For camera I use focus distance maybe somewhere here, maybe 600 focus distance will be. Also for this focus camera I am apply Redshift camera tag with bokeh. And I also apply Cinema 4D Vibrate tag, which is simulate moving of my camera, maybe just little bit. As you can see, when it start moving, and my camera have some moving, very nice. So render and check what I have. Yeah, as you can see, I already finished some renders for these tutorials. For my computer, it's taking five minutes. Yes, something strange. Yeah, I think. Yeah. Sorry. I have to find somewhere here. Yeah, 1 hour 55 seconds. 1 hour 55 seconds take my render. So now it's 6 seconds. Yeah, you see, it's very nice. Some ROPs. And looks like very nice. I have some bokeh. And what we will do now? We will apply some clouds for my sky. For clouds, I will create my sphere and make it very huge, big. I don't know, maybe 50,000, like this. It will be very, very big. I'm going to my sun, to project, and extrude the sphere. It means I don't need effect to the sphere, any connection of light. Very good. Create redshift material. Going inside, and I will use Material Blender, like this. So standard material will be no color, no reflection, 100 refraction and 1, just like a nothing. Apply like a base color, like this. After that, yeah, I think I already can apply some, like this. And why I cannot see nothing? Yeah, because my sphere not apply this material. Okay, yeah, you see, I have nothing. Very good. Now I create a self-illumination material, will be white color, apply it like a layer number 1. And for mask of this material, I will use a noise and I'll use a color correct. So apply noise, apply to color correct. And now we will check what I have. So color correct maybe will be 0.95. Just to reduce gray colors. Going to noise, and first of all it will be turbulence, and for coordinates, I don't know, I will use very small size, like this. Yeah, you see what I have? I have like some small clouds. And scale, I will change the scale. Here I will use 1, here I will use 1, and you see, and here I will use maybe 6. Just to make it more white. Maybe 5 will be also good. Okay, very good. And apply this mask to my layer number 1 blend color. And what I have? I have like this, some clouds. Looks like not so bad. Maybe I will reduce little bit contrast. Yeah, just to add little bit more clouds. And looks like very nice. So on the frame number 0, this sphere, now we will check where is the rotation of this sphere. I think here, yeah, this sphere have 0 rotation. On the frame number 500, last one, come on, one more, it will be, I don't know, maybe 20, just little bit rotation, just little bit. Okay, very good. And finally, what we will do finally, I'm going to this viewport, and you see, yes, my cloner start from here. Sorry, I take my cloner and put down many down. I like to receive nothing in my camera in beginning. So inside in the cloner, I will increase a quantity of my my balloons. I don't know, maybe will be 5, maybe will be 10, or maybe 6. Okay, I increase the size between these balloons, 7. Here will be maybe. Okay, very nice. Very nice. And put more down. Maybe like this. Okay. Do not apply too much if you have a not so powerful computer. Your computer can go into stuck. You will have a problem for sure. But when everything ready, I will show you first frame. Yeah, just a moment. Yeah, like this will be first frame. After that, I am push play and my balloons slowly can going up. Yeah, you see, first balloon going up with ropes. You see, it's really too much and looks like very nice. If I push it, just moment, somewhere pause. Again, render these pictures, and what I have now, you will check. We will check how many seconds. Yeah, and don't forget, yes, before for Redshift, they're going through some preparation. For example, if will be second frame or third frame, it will be more faster because now they calculate all my pictures, all my segments, reflection, everything. This is just only for first frame. I will show you now example, and look what I have. Looks like very nice, and it's taking 25 seconds. I will show you some small tricks. If I'm going to here, for example, without save, going to output and frame number 44 and then up to 46, just two frames more. Yeah, just for example, this will be 25. Yeah, I forget to put, and this will be 576. Okay, check again. I'm render again this picture like this. Yes, continues without saving, and check what I have. First coming preparation, like I told you, for first frame. Yes, it's taking maybe again approximately 20-25 seconds, but next frame and after next frame will be more faster. Now you will check it. Okay, applying some mesh, applying everything. Okay, first frame, you see 22 seconds, and second frame already start rendering, and you see second frame only 4 seconds. This is reason why I very like Redshift. You see, yes, 22 seconds with preparation, and after that 4 seconds with same quality of the picture. Okay, before final render, I will going to Redshift. I will increase, I don't know, maybe 64 segments, just to show you the very good quality. Yes, yeah, I think like this. Again render, continues without saving for a moment. Yes, because I am already finished my rendering with saving. Now I will check again the speed. Again preparation, I think approximately they need 15-20 seconds to prepare this frame. Now we'll check. Yeah, approximately 20 seconds they will prepare. And after that, you see, yes, very nice bokeh, blur. I can see very good quality of the ropes. And yes, very interesting reflection. Yeah, how many seconds? You see 42 seconds, first frame with preparation. And second frame, I don't know, I think will be less than 20 seconds, but now we will check it. We will wait a little bit just for one frame more. I am not continuous with rendering. Okay, 23 seconds. You see, it's very good. I think very good for this HD quality, for this, I don't know, reflection, for this blur effects. I think it will be very nice. So, when everything ready, going to output, going to all frames, save somewhere where is you like to save. I don't know, usually I use PNG file, and when everything will be done, when you have to go to Adobe After Effect. I will show you now how I will use Adobe After Effect. Yeah, now I have it. So double click, take first frame, import, push somewhere here, and what I have like this. My balloon is going up and this looks like very, very nice. Additionally, I will add some sounds. I already downloaded some sounds like this. First sound. This is like a bird. I hope you can hear it. And second sound like a children garden, maybe some schoolyard like this, and apply both of them, and I have like this. So my tutorial is completed. If you like it, please subscribe, share to your friends, and check all my other tutorials. See you next time. Goodbye, guys.